is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to Space Station Live. It is Thursday, August 29th, 2013. This is a live view inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. This team today being led by Flight Director Matt Abbott. He is sitting at the center console directing the team. He's there in the blue shirt. Sitting beside him in sort of the lighter color shirt is Jeremy Hansen. He is the CAPCOM for today and this team. Up on board the space station, we've got Expedition 36. The commander is Pavel Vinogradov. He is there second from the left. On the far left is Alexander Mazurkin. There in the back is Chris Cassidy. Beside him is Luca Parmitano from the European Space Agency. There in the front is Fyodor Yurchikhin. And on the far right-hand side is NASA astronaut Karen Nyberg. The crew is very busy today on board the space station itself. They're going to have a busy weekend as well. We have an update for you on this spacesuit investigation that has been continuing ever since July when Luca Parmitano and Chris Cassidy stepped outside and that water began leaking into Luca's helmet. There was a checkup that happened earlier this week where they basically recreated the problem. So what they're going to do is actually ask the crew to go ahead and swap out this water relief valve that is one of the suspects inside the suit. That will take place this weekend. What they will do after that is test out the suit once again. What this amounts to is basically just turning on the suit as if it were about to go out the door. Of course, Luca will not be on the inside of it, but that does allow them to verify whether the problem exists or not. So they will swap out that water relief valve, turn on the suit once again, check it out, see if that resolves the issue, and then they will remove and replace what is known as the gas trap. This is another piece of equipment inside the suit, and then we'll see where we're at. So again, that should take place on Saturday. All three of those tasks are going to be done by the crew. Karen Nyberg is actually already gathering the tools for that today. Of course, we will have an update for you on Monday as this activity continues to see if we can solve this issue with this specific spacesuit that Luca Parmitano did wear back in July. Chris Cassidy today also working with Robonaut. He has been doing some teleoperations with it. Basically, he puts on some virtual reality gear, some VR gear, and commands Robonaut through some paces. Basically controlling the robot himself. Robonaut can be controlled by the ground controllers here in Houston, or the crew itself can do it. So Cassidy was checking that out today, and everything went according to plan. Chris also working to gather up some items and some trash that are going to come home and be burned up in the atmosphere once Cygnus leaves the International Space Station. Of course, Orbital Sciences is getting ready to launch Cygnus, their cargo vehicle, on a test flight coming up on September the 17th. That is the targeted launch date. Launch time should be about 10:16 a.m. Central Time or 11:16 a.m. Eastern Time. If Orbital is able to launch Cygnus on that day, it should lead to a rendezvous on September the 22nd with the International Space Station when Luca and Karen will use the station's robotic arm to reach out and grab onto Cygnus and install it on the bottom side of the Harmony node. They will unpack about 1,300 pounds of cargo that's coming up. There's basically some non-critical crew supplies on board the spacecraft that are coming up on this test flight, but they will be packing it full of trash and other items that are no longer needed. And at the end of about a month up on board the space station, Cygnus will be undocked and be sent into a destructive reentry. So Chris is working today to gather up some of those items. Later on today, Chris and Karen will do an eye exam. What this is taking a look at this phenomena that some of the astronauts have seen on board where their vision gets a bit degraded. Their eyes do change a bit while they're up there. So this new vision test is something that the crew members do while they're up there to see if they can figure out exactly what could be causing this recent issue that they've seen with some of the astronauts and to determine what could possibly be causing it. Karen Nyberg and her fellow crew members Luca Parmitano and Fyodor Yurchikhin have been doing an emergency drill today. This is done every now and then just to keep their skills sharp, but they did climb into the Soyuz that brought them up to the station here several weeks ago and pretended like there was an emergency on board, ran through all the procedures for that, and then talked with the ground teams here on Earth about how that went. Alexander Mazurkin and Fyodor Yurchikhin have been continuing today to put up the tools that they used during their two spacewalks that happened last week and the week before. There's quite a bit of equipment that they needed for those spacewalks as they stepped outside and completed all their different tasks, including installing a rotating platform that'll be used for an upcoming telescope and also preparing the station for the arrival of the upcoming MLM module that will come up to the station here several months from now. So they're just gathering up the items that they had during that spacewalk and all the different tools and putting them back into the toolboxes on board the space station. Also, Vinogradov and Cassidy and Mazurkin getting ready to wrap up their time aboard the International Space Station. This crew is due to come home to Earth the evening of September the 10th. They each have some packing up time that will take place today. We want to remind you that that landing coverage will air live here on NASA television. Undocking should occur from the station at about 6:37 p.m. Central Time or 7:37 p.m. Eastern Time. And then landing will occur at 9:58 p.m. Central Time or 10:58 p.m. Eastern Time. Of course, our live coverage will be here on NASA television and also on the web at www.nasa.gov.